My first coffee I got this morning didn't quite last very long, so I'm here to grab a second one. Today seemed like a really good day for a vlog, so I thought, why not? You know, I haven't done one in quite a while. We got a few things to talk about. Just keep up throughout the day. All right, getting the stuff prepped now. I got a probe, our probe press. We got a meter. We got a customer that had a makeup line that froze. We had a meter ready for it, so we've got a technician on his way. He's going to pick that up. He's going to get that. I need to go see if we got pipe. All right, so we need just a piece of 1-inch pipe, or 1⅛ type L. Here's some 1⅛ right here. So this is 1-inch plumbing that'll work. Let's see what the plug in. Okay, so I'm going to set this out for the technician. I have looked. We do not have fittings sitting in the shop, which is okay. It's not a big deal. They'll just that's the only thing he'll have to pick up is some fittings to get this done. And there we go. That'll take care of that customer. And I've got this service call going. We had a pump go down on this plant, and we got technicians on site. They're currently working on it, getting it back online. I'm logged in through our Teams service into that customer's computer and kind of monitoring the plant and the boilers and how things are going currently, making sure everything catches back up and comes back online like it's supposed to. I'm also able to go in and look at all the inside units and see, you know, are they actually outputting the heat. So there's another part of my day.
Streets in Kiev today, with National Guard troops pictured lining up defensive positions along highways shortly before the sounds of gunfire and explosions rang out as they battle Russian forces for control of the capital city.
A U.S. official...
Get some lunch. For all the Jersey Mike guys out there, my preference is a 42 Chipotle chicken Philly cheesesteak with jalapenos. And we're back to paperwork, but I am going through and going over some inspection reports for chiller analysis. So when we do our annual inspections, which we do have some currently going on, we go through and take an oil analysis, send that into a laboratory, get it tested, and then they send it back the results. And we've got this one complex with 14 compressors total between 5 chillers. They definitely have some issues. I did get some weird moisture readings back on a few of them. Honestly, I feel like those readings are probably due to maybe just a little bit of mishandling when we were taking the analysis. These kits I find tend to be a little sensitive, and you got to be really careful when you're handling them because they will definitely, we're dealing with POE oil, it's going to absorb a lot of oil, and one of the things, and this is a good training opportunity for my team, and I've taught them, is 134 is a positive pressure, so you have to, after you take the sample, you have to let it sit open for a little while. So that it can kind of boil what little bit of trapped refrigerant bonds to the oil. So if it sits there open, it can do that. If you put the cap on too soon, the bottle will swell up and build pressure and blow oil all over the place. So that's what I teach them, but you have to be really careful and you have to really pay attention when you're doing it, because if you leave them open in the wrong place, or say, like we've had some weather recently where we've had these really humid mornings, we got fog and things in the air, if they're allowed to sit open for too long, that moisture will just grab into that POE oil because it's so hydroscopic. So I'm really wondering if that's the case. Most of these are very borderline. They're showing, we're talking like 100 to 150 ppm. There's one or two that are like 800, but those are also circuits that are actually down. So we have two circuits that are down. One of them is actually down for compressor bearings. And sure enough, that report, it came back with, you know, a ppm of 50 on iron is typically, you know, but top upper end of that range. And we were doing a little over 50, somewhere around 60 ppm. on your iron content, which is evidence of their bearing wear, which we already know. The compressor's already been condemned, so those types of things are just confirmations to what we've already determined outside of that. Something I wanted to bring up and talk about is I've actually got a Amazon store set up now, and I'm looking at integrating that into my website. And one of the things I'd really like to do with it is kind of showcase, one, the tools I use every day. A lot of what I have in there are things that I actually use and definitely things I recommend. I'm not going to put something in there that I wouldn't use myself or I wouldn't recommend for myself, or I don't try to encourage my technicians to purchase for themselves. With that, I do plan on kind of having a page on my website for a couple of things. One, have like an everyday carry list of items that I personally actually carry. It's in my tool bag. It's things that at any given point you run into me on the street, you're gonna see these tools on me. And then two, have a list of like, or a specialty list of different breakdowns depending on what type of role you do in this industry, whether you are more heavy mechanical, whether you're more chiller, RTU guy. Like, those are, I'm thinking through some of those things. That way it kind of helps give a guide as to what my recommendations are and what I've learned and what I see and the product specifically, more than just, you know, hey, if you're going to be a chiller tech, you need these types of tools, period. More than that, actually, I can recommend this specific tool for you that's going to take care of your needs and you're not going to have issues with it long term. Like, I want that kind of ease in the list. Something that I would love to hear from you on is, what tools do you want to know about? Like, what specifically are you interested in that I would suggest, I've used, and I would recommend at any given time? You know, and that could be any kind of range of things. Please leave a comment on it and let me know what are you interested in, or what would you recommend as some core fundamental tools and things, right? And I mean it at more than just I recommend having a megger. That's great. That's important. But what megger would you recommend, right? You know, are you going with Fluke? Are you maybe talking about the Klein? You know, what would you recommend for somebody specifically? Or even maybe a meter, you know, say, okay, you need to have a meter. That's great. There's 1,000 meters on the market. What would you recommend, or what are you interested in hearing maybe my opinion about, whatever. As that comes out and that develops, I'll talk more about that more later on, and I'll keep you updated as, you know, things happen with the website and all that goes down. So I won't leave you in the dark on it. I appreciate it, guys. Today was a good day. It was a lot of just very heavy admin day for me due to the weather and stuff we've got going on. We've got repairs and jobs and stuff going on, but I'm not, you know, heavily needed, and I've got a ton of backlog paperwork and all kinds of other stuff, which I normally do anyway, so it's what's new. I hope you enjoyed the vlog. Hope it was kind of fun, a little bit of a change up from a normal like service call or something like that. It just felt like a fun day to shoot one. I really enjoy doing these. I'd like to know, do you enjoy the vlogs? Do you have fun? Do you like my style? Like, I don't know, I love getting feedback on things, because it kind of helps me see, you know, how I can shape it to make it something even more fun in the end of the day. Anyway, MTT, take care of your family, take care of your spouse. Have a good one, fellas. Appreciate it.